Squatters steal soldiers' home until bikers appear. It was a huge, seething pile of bold-faced lies. What made it worse was there was nothing he could legally do about it. It was beyond insulting, especially for someone who had given years of service to his country. Thankfully, there was a biker gang that sympathized with his plight, and they were ready to act. For Michael Sharkey, serving in Hawaii was a vacation, at least compared to the previous tour in Afghanistan. He was beyond proud to serve in the U.S. military. He also counted his lucky stars that his wife was supportive of their nomadic lifestyle. But he would soon find out that not everyone respected the uniform. It started with a call from his wife. Her panicked, tear-laced words echoed through the phone and painted a shocking picture. The plan was for her to go to their home in Newport Richey, Florida, and get things ready for them to relocate after his term ended. It turned out the house wasn't empty. Michael felt the bile rise into the back of his throat. It seemed two people had taken up residency in the Sharkey home and refused to leave. It was a pile of lies right from the get-go, as the man claimed he had been given permission to stay there rent-free in exchange for fixing up the place. He couldn't believe what he was hearing. He had no idea who these people were. And by the time the police stepped in with answers, Michael was spitting fire. It turned out the two squatters, Julio Ortiz and Fatima Cardosa, were ex-cons with a combined, served sentence of 12 years. Things, however, got worse, and fast. The world no longer made sense. The sheriff's office tried to explain there was nothing they could do. Since the criminal couple had taken up residency, it was a civil matter and had to be taken to a judge for a formal eviction notice. Were they serious? Two slimy thieves had more right to his home than he and his wife did. And he was serving his country. This was insane. His rage boiled over when the news outlets got wind of the story and he saw the footage of the people that had stolen his home. The filthy lair stood, bold-faced in front of cameras and yelled how they were clean and had been given permission. Meanwhile, they had dozens of buckets around the yard to collect water, because no utilities were turned on. The footage cut to his distraught, teary wife. Michael couldn't take much more. Until his release papers came through, there was no way for him to go to Florida. It was beyond frustrating to feel so powerless, especially for a long-serving soldier. Part of him hated the glorification of his drams over the news feeds. However, it would turn out the footage was his saving grace. The infuriating situation didn't just land on sympathetic ears, it landed on some pretty scary brothers and sister. He had heard of bikers doing charity work. Things like escorting them to court so their horrible parents couldn't intimate them. Or, driving special needs kids to school so bullies left them alone. But this one group that had got wind of the Sharkey's plight weren't just bikers. They were military veteran bikers. The carjacking, drug-dealing couple were rainbows and kittens compared to what this collection of old soldiers had gone through, and they had a plan. There would be no violence. But their intimidating promise of peacefully making the squatters uncomfortable held endless, terrifying innuendo. The engines were barely running and ready to converge on the Sharkey home when Michael's wife called with an update. News of the escort had already reached Ortiz and Cardosa. Despite all the lies and screaming promises they would stay, it turned out they had done the smart thing and scuttled off in the middle of the night. The tactic had worked. Now, they had to deal with the aftermath. He was more than grateful for the help. After all, soldiers stuck together. But even with all the cleaning his wife had done before he finally was discharged home, the wear and tear from the squatters made the rage surface again. There was so much work ahead of them. It would take months and so much money to get their little nest back into something livable. But, at least with the help of his community, their home was finally theirs again. He just felt sorry for whoever owned the next building the squatter couple decided to steal,